हेलो गाइस, हाउ आर यू? सो इन दिस लेसन वी शैल स्टडी अबाउट द सेक्स डिटरमिनेशन। दिस कोर्स इज प्रेजेंटेड बाय मी नवनीत शर्मा। यू कैन नो मोर अबाउट मी फ्रॉम हियर। यू कैन फॉलो मी ऑन दिस लिंक एंड इफ यू लाइक द लेसन काइंडली रेट, रिव्यू एंड रिकमेंड। सो बिगनिंग विद द लेसन, सेक्स इज डिसाइडेड बाय क्रोमोजोम्स इन जनरल, बट इन सम ऑर्गेनिजम्स एनवायरमेंट एंड हॉर्मोन्स विल डिसाइड सेक्स। The organisms produce eggs. They are called as females. The organisms which produce sperms are called as males. Henking, found in some insects, the two types of sperms. Some sperms show an element and others lacking that element. This is essential for the sex determination. Miss Stevens gave complete account of chromosomal basis of sex determination, and she named it as X and Y chromosome. That is allosomes, and other chromosomes as autosomes. Okay, now allosomes, these chromosomes will carry genes for sex determination. They are X and Y chromosomes. And autosomes, the remaining chromosomes of nucleus are called as autosomes. They carry genes for vegetative characters. Now the chromosomal basis of sex determination, first one being XXXY type of sex determination. This is also called as ligands type of sex determination. This was described by Wilson and Stevens. First one is capital X, capital X female, and capital X, capital Y is male. Example is Drosophila and in man. The male shows XY allosomes. Two types of sperms are formed, capital X bearing and capital Y bearing. Now the sex is decided by the fertilizing sperm. Okay, you can refer to the diagram. As the female ova only contains XX chromosomes and male contains X and Y chromosomes, when they disaggregate in other gametes. Okay, so when the gamete with Y chromosome fuses with the female gamete, XY is formed and a male is formed. Okay, again, when the X chromosome from male sperm is fused with the female ova, XX is formed and again a female is formed. Okay, so two things can be deduced from here. First one being is that male is responsible for the sex determination. And secondly, there are 50-50% chances of being a male or female. Okay, similar is the case with Drosophila. Okay, so next we have XY female and XX male. For example, birds, moths, and butterfly. In these animals, Q is represented by a 2, that is XX or ZZ male. The female is XY or ZW, for example, bird. Okay, ZZ or XX represents the male, and ZW or XY represents the female. Here it is the opposite case. Okay, the male XX and female XY, the sex is decided by the type of egg which is fertilized. Okay, here the female is the deciding part. Now the protoneer type of sex determination, XX female and XO male. For example, it is seen in grasshopper. In these animals, sex is decided by a number of X chromosomes. The male has only one X chromosome. In the female, two X chromosomes are present. For example, Anessa. The 20 autosomes and one X chromosome shows monosome, that is the 21. The female has 20 autosomes and two X chromosomes. Thus, the total number of chromosomes is 22 in the females, and it is 21 in the males. Okay, so the male has 20 autosomes and XO, and female has 20 autosomes and XX. Okay, now diploid females and haploid males. This is also called as hymenopter type of sex determination. For example, honeybee, wasp, ant, etc. In these individuals, three types are recognized. First one being diploid queen. Second one is diploid workers, and third one is diploid haploid drones. A diploid queen is fertilized eggs will develop into fully developed functional females, and in the diploid workers, they develop from fertilized eggs. They are underdeveloped and they are non-functional females. They cannot reproduce. Then we have the haploid drones that are males. These are developed from the haploid unfertilized egg. Okay, they are functional males and they can produce sperms, but they are developed from unfertilized eggs only. Patterson discovered that in Drosophila, Y chromosome will not play a part in sex determination. A single dose of X chromosome in a diploid individual will make it male. The two doses of X chromosome in diploid individual will make it female. Bridges proposed thus the gene balance theory. According to this theory, the sex is developed basing on the male or female determining genes. If there is excess of female determining genes, it develops into a female. And if there is excess of male determining genes, it will develop into a male. Thus, the X chromosome in Drosophila carries more genes that incline towards femaleness. The autosome will possess genes which incline towards maleness. Hence, in Drosophila, sex is decided by a ratio between X chromosomes and sets of autosomes. Goldschmidt work on gypsy math, which can also be called as Limantria disper. This moth shows different geographical races. They occur in Europe, North America, and Japan. In European species, the sex factors are weak. In Japan, races and sex factors are strong. In gypsy moth, maleness is carried on chromosome, and factors for femaleness are seen in Y chromosome and cytoplasm. Goldschmidt crossed European weak female with Japanese strong male. This resulted in all male offsprings were normal. All the female offsprings were intersex. He crossed a Japanese strong female with European weak male. The result is all offsprings were normal. If European weak male with Japanese strong male were crossed, one Japanic race X chromosome cannot totally dominate the female characters of and the cytoplasm of European race. Hence, the doctor is intersex. Now, sex determination in hydrocarbon insect. Sex is decided by the presence of XA, XB, XC, XCI, etc. alleles. The fertilized eggs will become females. Unfertilized eggs will become males. If closely related insects take up sexual reproduction, the homozygous diploid males will develop. All the heterozygous diploid will become the females. Then in an organism, externally both female and male characters are exhibited. Such organisms are called as gynandomorph. Thomas Hunt Morgan, C.B. Bridges and Goldschmidt observed gynandomorphs in Drosophila, silkworms, etc. Depending upon the female and male characters on the body, external and three types of gynandomorphs are recognized. Bilateral gynandomorphs. In this type of flies, one of lateral sides possess female characters and the other side possess male characters. For example, Drosophila and silkworm. Anterior-posterior gynandomorphs. The organism's anterior side has male characters and posterior side has female characters, for example, Leucunus and sex piebalds. This type of organism mainly recognized as of male or female. However, the opposite sex characters are exhibited and on and off on the body, for example, Drosophila. Okay, these were the gynandomorphs. So this lesson ends here. I hope you guys liked the lesson. Thank you guys for watching. Keep learning.